What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to M.A.D. Detailing. Today's video is on a 1990 dump truck that has been sitting for the past 12 years. And as you guys see, this vehicle is covered from front to back in algae and mold, and the aluminum is in terrible condition. And even after we get all this algae removed, you guys will see that it takes a lot of polishing to bring this paint back to life. In total, we spent over 100 hours transforming this dump truck back to its factory condition. So take a second and make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel with the notification turned on. And let's see if we can get this video to 10,000 likes in the first week. I know you guys can do it. With that being said, we're gonna go ahead and roll these before shots and get right into this dump truck detail. And starting off this detail with getting all the algae removed, I'm simply using our M.A.D. Detailing Extreme All-Purpose Cleaner, diluted 4-to-1 in a pump-up sprayer, and then I'm gonna simply spray it off with a pressure washer. And honestly, it's super satisfying to watch, but when I was doing it, I got completely soaked and covered in this algae. So yeah, it's definitely more satisfying to watch than it was to do, but either way, I hope you guys enjoy. So if you guys remember in a previous video, I asked you guys if you would like to fly out to Florida and be in one of these disaster details. And honestly, in the next couple months, I'm going to make that a reality and I'm going to fly one of you guys down here. But the question is, do you guys want to do a barn find, a moldy detail like this, or would you guys like to do a nasty repo disaster? Because it's going to be your guys' choice, and we're going to do a full video, and it's going to be a lot of fun. So leave a comment down below on which vehicle you would like to do and why. So moving on to cleaning the engine bay, I'm now using our M.A.D Detailing Extreme APC, and I opted to use it full strength for this because there is a lot of built up motor oil and grease. And then I'm gonna simply spray it off with the pressure washer. And if you guys are wondering, yes, this is 100% safe and is the only way to deep clean an engine bay. And moving on to cleaning the wheels, I'm using our M.A.D Detailing Extreme APC again on the tires. And for the wheels, I'm using our M.A.D acid. And I know these are raw aluminum, so the acid is maybe gonna turn it a chalky white color, but that's gonna be the first step in polishing them because there is a ton of oxidation on these wheels. And the M.A.D acid is gonna simply remove that and make the polishing 10 times easier. So moving on to cleaning the underneath, I'm using our pressure washer to blow away all the loose dirt and grime, and then I'll use our Extreme APC full strength again. I'll get that pressure washed off, and then I'll give the tire underneath an acid bath, and that's gonna remove a lot of the rust, dirt, and grime, because a customer did ask if we could paint the entire underneath. So I need to get the entire under, how many times am I gonna say that? Either way, I gotta get the tire underneath as clean as possible. That way the paint will bond and last for years to come. Before I can finally start washing this dump truck, I'm going to give all the raw aluminum a good acid wash. So moving on to a contact wash, I'm now using a foam cannon and our M.A.D Detailing Super Glue Soap, and I'm only going to wash one half of the dump truck at a time, because if I were to just spray the entire truck down with soap, it would be dry by the time I got to the other side. So I'm going to spray one side, wash it, spray it off, and then move on to the other side. And after what seemed like 6.5 days, I'm finally ready to work on the interior. So there's not a lot of trash and debris, so I'm simply using our compressed air. I'm gonna blow out the floorboards, the dash, and all the door panels, and then move on to cleaning the seats with our Extreme APC as a cleaner, followed by a Milwaukee drill with a drill brush attachment. And for the extractor, I'm using my Mighty HP 120 hot water extractor. And honestly, these seats didn't look too bad, but as you guys can see, they are pretty filthy. Thank you. And moving on to cleaning the interior panels, I'm now using our M.A.D Clean all-purpose cleaner and a soft detail brush. I'm also using a steamer to make sure I loosen up all this dirt and grime. And then I'm using our compressed air to blow out all the tight cracks and crevices. That way, when I walk away later on, it doesn't seep out and run down all the panels. Before I can move on to any type of polishing, I need to clay bar the dump truck, and for this I'm using our M.A.D detailing clay lube and a synthetic clay bar. And as you guys can see, the paint on this dump truck is in really rough shape and is extremely oxidized. So the fastest way to remove this oxidation is going to be using a rotary polisher. So I'm using a DeWalt rotary with a wool pad. And for the compound, I'm using Sonex Ultimate Cut. So one tip for using a rotary polisher, if you guys can see at the very beginning, I always spread out my compound first. That's pretty obvious, but I'm using the buffer on the actual, like, kind of the side. I'm not completely, you know, fully tilted, but I'm leaning on one side. I'm going to go left to right and then up and down, and then I'll put the polisher completely flat. And what that's going to do is actually going to level out some of the swirls, and it's going to make it easier for polishing later on. Even though I'm going to use a DA, you know, if you can leave the least amount of swirls possible with using rotary, always do that. And also one thing that I'm doing is I'm blowing out my pad after every single pass, because there is a lot of oxidation and paint transfer going on in my pad. But either way, even if there wasn't and this was a base clear, you always want to blow out your pad, because you are always removing some type of clear or some type of contaminants onto your pad. And if you're not blowing them out frequently, your pad is going to start cutting less and less. So always make sure you blow out your pad after every single pass.
Thank you.
And moving on to polishing the aluminum, the customer didn't even ask for us to be polished, but we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit anyways. So we're not gonna do a complete restoration on all this aluminum because honestly, I don't even have the equipment to really do it because I told myself a long time ago, I was never gonna do aluminum again after I did this entire truck one time. It took way too long. And honestly, it's probably my least favorite thing to do. So I'll leave it up to the guys that do polishing full time because it's really not my thing. So yeah, the wheels came out almost like brand new, but the tanks, they had to be completely sanded down to get, you know, mirror-like results. But in the end, it came out really decent and the customer was extremely happy. So that's all that matters.